Hey folks, I hope y'all are all doing really well. Guess what? Today we are going to be dealing in Ford minutia. And I know if you're a Ford guy like me, Ford minutia is always good fun. So what we're going to be talking about today is me backstepping just a tiny bit on the Ford Granada spindle and saying there are certain applications where I think they work very, very well. But before we get into that, do me a favor, go out and subscribe to the channel. Whack that like button, smash the bell to be notified of all of our videos that we're putting up both on Autorestomod and here on Manic Mechanic. Check out the description below, because in the description below we list who we got the parts from with a website connecting them and with the part number, so you can get right out there and grab those parts. Another thing I'd like for you to do finally before we move on from here is to go out and leave a comment in the section below. Let us know what you think about what we're doing here. Tell us whether you like this. Tell us if we're screwing up with some of the information, because my gosh, there's going to be a lot of information today.
Autocrafters, your source for Falcon, Fairlane, Full Size, Mustang, Maverick, Pinto, Ford Truck, Cougar. Contact us at www.autocrafters.com.
All right, so what we're going to be talking about is how this spindle can apply and where I think it best fits. And the short answer to that question is, if you want to use a Granada spindle, if you're married to that idea, then this spindle will work on 1966 to 1971 Fairlane, Torino, Montego, Comet, as well as 1967 to 70 Mustang, 1967 to 70 Cougar, and the 1970 to 1977 Maverick. And I'll go over some of the little idiosyncrasies in there between those after we get through talking about all the little doodly-doo on this spindle. Simply put, this is a nice pedestrian disc brake assembly for your car. Caveat number one, availability. Now, you can now get this spindle brand new. It is being reproduced so that you can put the Granada brakes on here. Calipers are available, brake lines are available, bolts, mounting brackets, all that stuff you can get brand new to put this together. I'm not sure of the costing on it, so I'm not going to go into all that, but I'm just letting you know that the spindle is available as a new item. Finding them in the junkyard? No. You're not going to do it. They're just not out there. I mean, there are some, and if you find them in the junkyard, 99 chances out of 100, the disc brakes are missing off of them if they're there. There's a junkyard that we have north of here that has four Granadas in it and one Versaille. All of them are missing the spindles off of them. So what I'm going to talk about next is what you can find and the part numbers if you buy, say, a set of spindles online from a supplier on eBay or somewhere like that. Now, if it's a Granada spindle, typically it's going to be a D5DW3107 or that same number with a 08 at the end of it for the one side or the other. So you have a 3107 and a 3108. Those are the two different sides. Ford did that a lot. They would have the right and left numbered consecutively. Another thing you'll find some of is there's also another set of numbers I've seen online, which is a D7AA. I don't know what the change point is on that. I don't know why Ford went away from the D5DW and went to the D7AA. It's numbered a little different because it has a Ford oval on it with a number after that. The numbers that I have found are a 177 and a 173. I don't know if those are the same side or not. I was not able to get that information in researching all of this. Now, I'm going to talk about some of the positives. One thing is I'm pretty sure on the Granada that this line here is not centered up, that the top of the spindle where it bolts to the upper control arm is kicked back about 3 degrees, giving you a much better caster signal out of the front of the car. That's a good thing. That does help. But you can get that same kind of thing by putting 3/8 of shims on a drum brake spindle. So I'm not sure it's really a super big advantage. It has a beefier spindle on it on the very front. Let me spin this thing around. If you're looking at it, the actual spindle assembly on here inside of this is a bigger spindle, but that's the same thing as the 1970 had. The 1970 Ford spindles were a larger spindle inside of here, thus this is a larger sleeve point on the top of it. Now, beyond that, I'm going to start talking about where we start hitting some negatives on this. If you're doing a set of these on a 1966 Fairlane or a 1967 Fairlane or also a 1967 Mustang and you want to go with your stock wheels for whatever reason, ain't going to happen. Because the center on the wheel is smaller than this sleeve is on here because of the bigger bearing. Now, if you got a set of 68s, it's going to be the same problem. This sleeve is bigger on a 68 Mustang disc brake system as well. All of these are also 11-inch rotors, and that's for the Versaille as well as the Granada, because the Versaille uses the same basic parts as the Granada with one weird exception. They use a much larger lower ball joint on the inside here. This hole is much bigger on a Versaille, so you're going to have to look out for that. If you get a set of Versaille spindles, I'll give you the part numbers on those right now. That's really heavy. The part numbers for the Versaille are a D7DY, and that's a 3105 and a 3106. Those spindles are actually bigger ball joints, and you'll have to get the sleeves from Mustang Steve. I'll put the URL for that below me here, as well as in the description below, so you can check that out and go check out Mustang Steve. These calipers are too big to run the stock wheels on your early car like that, but if you have a 1968 on up or a set of aftermarket wheels, not going to be an issue in either place, because all aftermarket wheels are done in the 1968 on up specification. Only the early wheels have a problem mounting this spindle. The tie rod end will require you to use the 1975 Granada tie rod end for it, because those are specifically set up to run with this particular mounting setup on the tie rod end of this. So just make sure you're going to get those whenever you do it. And really, honestly, that's it. That's the biggest things. I'm going to now talk about some of the things that are an issue on these from a performance standpoint. I'm going to flip this thing back around again. Now, in looking at this on the front, you have an 11-inch rotor and you have a single piston caliper. And if you go and do anything performance on this, you're going to have an 11-inch rotor and a single piston caliper. You can get some mild performance pads for this. You cannot get a bigger rotor. You cannot get a different mounting bracket, at least as far as I could find in my research online. I know that Street or Track had talked at one point about making a setup so that you could move this caliper out to get a larger rotor on here. I don't know that that ever came to fruition. If it did, and Sean, if you're watching this from Street or Track, let us know and we'll put something in the description to say that you can get a different caliper mounting bracket to allow you to use different calipers on here. You can get slotted rotors. You can also get cross-drilled rotors from what I've seen. My personal opinion, for what it's worth, on cross-drilled rotors is I don't do them. You're taking braking surface away from something that's already an 11-inch rotor? I'd rather have the braking surface. Because all you're really trying to do, quote-unquote, with the cross-drilling is lighten the rotor up so it's not as heavy. You could do just about as much by going and getting a super light set of wheels to put on here from someone than cross-drilling these rotors. Now, the clean-out slots that you'll see in them going around the rotors, I think those are a worthy cause. I would probably go ahead and get those on here. But other than that, you got nothing. There's nothing available for these in the performance aftermarket like there is for the drum brake spindles, which is where we're going next. The drum brake spindle. This sucker was around from 1966 under the C6OA part prefix in a 3107 or a 3108. All the way up through 1969, where they changed the part number to a C9OZ3105 and a 3106. And if it was a midsize and smaller car, meaning that the Falcon had moved up into the midsize ranks as far as body size, they just shortened it a little bit on either end, it got this spindle. If you were driving a Maverick with drum brakes, it got a basic line of this spindle. Now, I will say that the other nice thing about these suckers is there is an aftermarket one available to replace this. And the new spindle actually has the 70 spindle on the front of it, which is a bigger, meatier spindle, a bigger bearing assembly, and it also has a bigger tie rod in on the outside to give you that extra oomph you need for what we're basically doing a lot of now, which is a lot bigger wheel and tire package on the car. Are there brake systems available for these suckers? Holy smoke. Now, in all honesty, Ford did have a disc brake system in 1966 and 67 on the GTs that was a four-piston caliper system for it, which was a nice operating system and which is the basis for everything you see out there right now. If you're looking at a disc brake kit for your car, and I'm not going to go into all of those because, my gosh, we could be here for weeks, it's based off of that Kelsey Hayes mounting bracket and mounting system and four-piston caliper. So this spindle is good for that. And that is the one thing I do like about the drum brake spindle. It does not have the 3-degree offset like the Granada spindle has, but you can put that in by putting shims in the front of your control arm on a 1967 on up Mustang or a 1966 on up Fairlane. And when I say those two, I'm talking about the subgroups underneath them as well, because I don't want to stand here and say that whole line of cars all day long. It just takes forever. The cool thing is you can do that shim modification. We've got a video, the link for the URL is below me here, where we do the 3/8 of shims. That's an Aussie upgrade that they do down under on their XY and XW GTs, which moves the front of the control arm out, effectively dropping that spindle back. Do that and you get the same thing you get with the Granada spindle, and you can get 13-inch rotors with 6-piston calipers if you want, because they're just available out there. This is a good spindle. If you have got a car with a V8 in it with these spindles on it, just go ahead and rock it down the road. Your Fairlane will handle real well with this. With a nice disc brake kit on the front of it, you'll be able to stop on a dime, or at least on a dollar bill. Because, I mean, I never thought about it. Stopping on a dime just seems really hard. It's very small. So just kind of keep that in the back of your mind. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to pull this out of the way. I'm going to pull the Granada spindle back in because I do not have a 1968 on up Ford disc brake system. But the Granada, it'll stand in because they look a lot alike. So we're going to take this one out of the way. What we've got here is a Granada spindle, which basically is the same thing as a 1968 to 1969 disc brake spindle. The big difference on these is the outer tie rod end is smaller on the 68 and 69, and the spindle is a little bit smaller. In 1970, they changed the part number to a D00Z3105, and this spindle in the center became larger. The ones that you get in the aftermarket are basically the Granada spindle. The other thing I don't know for sure on these is if it has the offset for the upper control arm like the Granada spindle has. I have to believe it probably didn't, because the part number did change to a D5DW. So as I wreck my table even more and put this back in position, basically the brake system is the same. It's an 11-inch rotor with a single piston caliper. Ford thought, what the heck? Who needs all that performance with 4-piston calipers and stuff? We'll just put a single piston caliper on here and call it good. These were available pretty much only with power assist on a factory application. There are some cases where I've seen 428 and other drag cars with factory disc brakes without power on them, but most of those I've seen are special order cars. And the Maverick. In 1974, it did not have power brakes available. It only had a standard brake available. And that was because they couldn't figure out how to get the booster in that corner where it needed to go with the export brace, because, you know, the export brace had to go out around the booster. I have a hope to find a picture to show you that. If I do, it's right here, so you can see exactly what Ford did, which is really weird looking. But I guess it worked. Who knows? Now, the same thing applies to these as applies to the Granada spindles. The 68 and 69 all the way up, they don't bolt up to the stock wheels for 66 and 67 because they have the smaller center hole on the wheel and the shape on the backside of the wheel collides with the caliper. So that's really not any different than the other ones. Well, I hope you enjoyed that spindle ad nauseum. No, I did. I researched the piss out of this thing and I think I may have left out like 3 or 4 things, but I'm sorry. You guys have a great week. Be good to each other, love on each other, and we'll see you on down the road. Now, to find another tabletop for this table, because I just wrecked the piss out of this one.